If you're a developer, then you're a pattern collector. Patterns essentially make you faster, make you more proficient. They let you write and understand code much faster with a lot less effort. And when it comes to automated testing, one of the most common patterns out there is the AAA pattern or the 3A's pattern, which is Arrange, Act, and Assert. So in this video, we're going to look at the AAA pattern. The Arrange, Act, and Assert pattern is a software development testing pattern that allows you to write and read testing code much faster. It also allows you to pick up and fix errors in those tests as well. So the first A stands for Arrange. This is the stage where you set up everything so that the test produces accurate results. Usually this involves creating classes, setting up variables or initializing variables, setting up mocks to simulate external services, creating test data, or even setting up your system as a whole. The goal of the Arrange phase is to set up an environment to ensure that the following assertions and actions happen inside a predictable scenario. This approach and overall the pattern ensure that the test is written in a predictable format, so they're easier to read and they also reduce the chances of flaky tests. The second A stands for action. Here's where we interact with whatever piece of code we're trying to test, be it calling a method, calling a function, or even calling some sort of external API. Whatever we want to test, here is where we do that, where we write that test, where we write that code. Just a single line of code is enough. It doesn't have to be a complicated thing. The goal of the act phase is to get an output that is verifiable in the next stage, which leads us to the final A. Assert. Here is where you verified essentially the outcome from your automated test and make sure that it matches your expected results or your expectations. Usually this involves using some sort of assertion method and comparing the actual value with the expected one. Some examples of assertion methods include making sure that a specific method returns the expected value, or making sure that an object changed its state as expected, or even making sure that an expected exception was thrown during execution. And as a general rule of thumb, to maintain a general readability and effectiveness of your tests, it's usually recommended to keep the number of assertions to a minimum to reduce the complexity of the test. If you need more, create more tests. Now let's see what the AAA pattern looks in reality in an actual test. So to get started, for the arrange phase, we just set up the conditions. We initialize an input array with some values, that's it. Then during the act phase, we actually call the method. We call the indexOf method here, but note that we're not doing any assertion or evaluation at this stage. Finally, in the assert stage, we compare the result that we got with the expected output, in our case, one. If we want to run this test, we would get an error like this, showing exactly where the error lies. We can see at a glance that the arrange stage and the act stage worked correctly. There is no error during those stages. The error comes exactly during the assert phase because we're expecting the value to be a -1 and we actually compare it to a 1. We can easily fix this by going back to the test and adding the minus sign that we were missing. Now, the good news is that the arrange, act, and assert pattern is not really tied to any specific language. So it means that you can apply it to any environment, to any language, it doesn't really matter. But the question though is, why would you? Let's talk about reasons why you would want to use this pattern in your code. The first one is better code organization. Following this pattern, you ensure that most, if not all of your tests have the same structure or a very similar one, which makes it easier to read and easier to maintain, which leads us to better readability. Not only of the code, but also predictable pattern also ensures that reading error messages also lets you know at a glance where the error is inside a specific test, makes it a lot easier. And even though that might sound like a very trivial benefit, it is when you only have one or 2-10 tests, but when you have hundreds, if not thousands of tests in a huge system, this little benefit becomes huge. T TDD support. Essentially, the AAA pattern encourages you to use TDD. Essentially, it gives you the steps and the structure to set up a test of expected results without code actually being there to produce it. So it is essentially, it goes hand in hand with the methodology that you need to create the test for TDD. They're easier to refactor, essentially, and again, comes with the idea of the predictable pattern, the predictable structure for all tests. You know where you have to go when you need to make a change on any of your tests. For example, if you know that you have to change the way you call a method or the type of, you know, variables that you give, that you pass to a method during the act phase, you know where in your test you have to go to make that change. You know you don't have to go anywhere else. So it's, again, reducing the cognitive load required to make small changes, to make small adjustments, which in the long run adds up with a huge benefit. The separation of concerns also is a huge benefit because you know that the test is structured in a way that makes it easier to deal with, essentially, because you know that whatever setup you need is within the arrange phase. Whatever call, whatever method call, whatever interaction that has to happen is within the act phase, and all the assertions are at the bottom in the assert phase. So essentially, reduces code complexity within tests, which again can be a huge benefit in terms of maintainability on the long run. And finally, it is an industry standard. After years and years of evolution, the AAA pattern has become one of the de facto ways in which to write tests. So you're not the only one doing it. You're not alone, essentially. Now, I'm sure you've seen this pattern already many times, or even you were using it before even knowing that it had a name and a formal definition. Now, the point is that the AAA pattern is a great tool for writing and reading tests. So make sure you use it. Now, if you want to know more about the pattern, you have a full-blown article in the blog where you can see all the details and learn more about it than with this video. So make sure to follow the link in the description of the video to know more. And that's it. Thank you for watching. I'm Fernando, and I hope you liked the video. If you did, make sure to leave a like and subscribe to the channel for more content like this. Thank you for watching, and I'll catch you on the next one.